Hey guys, it's your boy Cooperz, and welcome back to my FIFA 17 Atletico Madrid career mode, where last time I left off, I picked up a win in the league over Malaga, and I defeated Bruges in a Champions League, and not only progressed to the knockout stages, but I topped the group because other results went my way. In this episode, what I've a game against Real Sociedad and a derby match against Real Madrid. I've already beaten Barcelona earlier in the season. Defeating Real Madrid, who have really turned their form around. In fact, they've climbed up into, I think, sixth place. Directly above Real Sociedad, actually. Funnily enough.
Welcome to you all. I'm Martin Tyler. Alan Smith is with me as always. Not to make any slips in the commentary, but there might be some slips out on the pitch, Alan, in these wet conditions.
Yeah, and I don't think it's going to stop during the course of the match, so I don't think it's going to affect the game in any way in terms of calling it off, but it might get very wet for the players.
Real Sociedad play today. They play Atletico Madrid.
There we go. They're up in fifth place. Real Sociedad are in sixth. And Barcelona is in fifth,
Antoine Griezmann is a great goal scorer without having that sort of single-mindedness.
Yeah, Real Madrid, he sort of hangs around the goal to get his chances. Really bad really start for the team as
well. Well, I think that's inspired by Diego Simeone.
Gotten back on track.
I think he's got the Frenchman.
Probably a little too late, but you know.
Real Sociedad's lineup. Inigo Martinez starts despite looking shaky in recent games.
Gazpacho
plays with Granero in the center of the pitch. And they just go with the one striker up front. Quite a few changes for Atletico Madrid. Starting in goal, Jan Oblak. Plays with Miranda in central defense. Koke starts alongside Saul in the middle of the park. And in attack, Antoine Griezmann partners together with Angel Correa. It's out, it'll be a throw. It's out for a throw for moving forward with some danger to the opposition. Now they're here. Crisp defending there. Not rushing it here. Moving from one side to the other. Looked very good indeed, but the move has broken down. It's a quick break.
Griezmann, thrown goal. Can he make it 1-0?
Oh! Miss, a narrow miss. Otherwise, we'd have been talking about one of the goals.
How did I not score there?
Cut through the defence on the breakaway, and all it needed was a composed head at the end.
Better for Antoine.
Well, that's straightforward for the goalkeeper.
Griezmann.
Then in the shot, goal!
Correa! 1-0.
They go in front.
And that's a
slick attack.
Big goal. Well, for this
season. The position sets up against them. They have the power.
And because that puts Correa level with Griezmann.
And as you've seen, yet again, it's really effective.
Both are on 16, I think? Or is it 17? 16.
So the first goal, it's 1-0.
So, 1-0. Both my strikers are on 16 goals and they're tripping over each other. They're so excited. Or was that somebody else?
Nicolas Gaitán.
Sorry, that was Koke.
good
pass. A lot of these guys have dark hair. It's hard to tell. Challenges them apart.
For the ball. And it's the goalkeeper's ball, quite clearly. A wasted cross. Home team have some work to do, Alan, because they've lost their last two games. They've got home advantage. They need to win today.
Yeah, they do put pressure on them in front of their own fans, but I fancy them to do it here, actually.
Especially when they're all piling forward. Come on, Griezmann. That's going to be a free kick. No, that's not a yellow card. Pretty much the same foul committed in the last episode. A little heavier, I'll admit that. It's my bad, though. It's my bad. Don't even worry about it. Nothing to get too stressed about.
Crisp defending there.
I'm going over why it's not a yellow card way after he hasn't even shown the yellow card. So
for the visiting team today, because
clearly the referee is like, yeah.
Run to 10 consecutive victories.
Well, that's something to aim for, and what a marvellous total it would be. They played some great stuff, really good.
Can someone move this guy to the Premier League?
Madrid, they do have the lead. Oh, he's through.
I mean, a guy like this in the Premier League, they give out yellow cards for the moment. Bullshit,
trying to cross it, and in the end,
bullshit.
A bit of a waste, I think.
Did I mention it was
definitely
bullshit?
A throw in there.
If you know what I'm talking about, well, just wait.
Now they've got a chance in this part of the pitch. Griezmann! Oh, what a fine goal! They lead by two now. They'll feel a little bit more comfortable.
I think it's the one before this video, so it would have been out yesterday.
And that goal for Atletico Madrid.
He could hardly miss that from the right wing. That was a perfect delivery.
And they got their reward for it.
Well, do you know what? I thought he was going to head that ball, but he's adjusted his body, and what a finish.
As Griezmann
just wide
2-0 and retakes the lead in the top goal scorer standing.
Ball back, the interceptor got it for them, and the time to be added on here is a minimum of 3 minutes.
No, my bad, this
the break is definitely on.
I miss.
He's had to go full stretch.
Calculate, this is not Tuesday's video, this is Thursday's video.
Is the score at the half?
The video I am thinking of, the Look Promo video, I think is going up on Monday, if I am thinking of the right one. So confused. I'm recording some which I don't know which is which. I need a break, I really do.
Well, we've got a substitution now. So the referee's happy, the players are in position, the second half gets underway. Okay. This is how they love to play on the break.
Correa.
Well, they've wasted that crossing position, haven't they?
Lock.
Easily cleared. He's better usually at crossing than that.
Ball.
The defender who got there first quite easily, actually. Griezmann.
Crasco.
He's got his shot off now.
Go for goal! Just over the bar. So close.
Atletico Madrid.
Across the Correa, 3-0.
And he's done it.
Oh, that should be the end. Of Real Sociedad. Finished. Complete.
He's an
done.
Impetuous goal.
3 points.
This
one. Three
more
points
here.
In
well,
the
well.
Bag.
The score was
once again equals.
To make him pay, good finish.
Don't worry.
That's given them a comfortable situation here. 3-0 as the game gets underway.
Talking about it.
The change in tactics maybe from Real Sociedad, that they're going to bring on someone from the bench. Granero. Just a heavy touch, the opposition could take the ball away.
Griezmann.
Attacking well here. Lost it. Great chance! Mm-hmm.
Made that run. Koke! Oh! Should have scored there, Koke. Come on.
Atletico Madrid. Godin! He's got to it, and he's claimed the ball too. On EA Sports, a chance to see the La Liga fixture, Real Sociedad. They'll be facing Sporting Gijón away from home.
Yeah, 3 points at stake. It's a big match for both sides.
Gonna try it! Good stop by the goalkeeper.
Win the header, or let it fall to your feet. That's also acceptable there for Luis.
Well, he could be in. Keeper's ball.
For hit it, man. Come on, Saul.
Of the 90 still
to play.
Do
better than that with your passes.
Trying to switch on the attacking power in this situation. Well, he's beaten his man. A real chance here.
Avoids them all. And scores.
On to Andreas Mann. And he's
I put him and Correa both on braces. Two players chasing a hat trick.
Two for him on the day. And two very well taken goals. It's turning out to be a comfortable game, this 4-0.
So it won't be from the lack of trying. Of course, other players will be trying to score as well.
Felipe Luis. Good position. They've worked this attack very well into a quite a dangerous position now. The shot's on! Take the chance with the shot there.
Ooh. Yeah, thought he might have done better there. Had a bit of time and space. Good position.
He'll need to try and get the ball back now. Oh, chance! Oh, well done.
Easy.
Well, they were leading at half-time, Atletico Madrid. It wasn't straightforward in the second half, but they still have their lead. And the clock
Griezmann.
Is their friend in these circumstances. Not long
to go. Set Carrasco through on goal. Carrasco!
Very good stop here.
Back into the box. Clear the way.
Shots on here. He's blocked that.
Carrasco's
well.
Shot is blocked.
Five.
Get a hold of the ball. Way.
Crisp defending there.
Oh, Godin has it. Look it in. Griezmann. Was a diving header really necessary there? I mean, you missed it by a smallest bit, yeah. But if you were standing up, you would win that no problem.
The break is definitely on.
Griezmann, good hit from the Sociedad keeper, really. Salt.
Oh, well saved. That's the final whistle.
And there's the full-time whistle. No hat trick for Griezmann or Correa.
It emphasizes what we've seen. 4-0
win.
The game as well. Very one-sided.
Well, it was a nice, comfortable
first whistle.
Win.
They were on top. It never altered for the entire 90 minutes. Wonderful stuff.
It was absolutely extraordinary, exceptional, elegant, excellent.
Well, so often we think of his creative abilities, but a couple of goals here have won the match for his team.
Good win. gives me perfect momentum going into the game against Real Madrid.
Sporting Gijón 2, Celta de Vigo 1, Valencia 2, Real Sociedad 0, Atletico Madrid 4, Sevilla 1, Barcelona 1, Villarreal 1, Real Betis 1.
Stamina, Griezmann. And the least you could do is go up in stamina just a small bit.
30 points. In second, Espanyol with 23 points. In third, Villarreal with 23 points.
Some people, am I right?
Barcelona with 20 points.
No.
In fifth, climbing the table are Valencia with 20 points.
No.
In sixth and falling are Real Madrid with 19 points. In seventh, moving down, are Real Sociedad with 17 points. In eighth, Eibar with 16 points. Bottom of the table, Osasuna with 4 points. And then reading up the table, second bottom, Real Betis with 6 points. Third bottom, Deportivo La Coruña with 9 points. Fourth bottom, Deportivo La Coruña with 10 points. Fifth bottom and falling are Celta Vigo with 11 points.
About international breaks. And if what happened in the Wales and Ireland game is anything to go by, people will soon see things my way. International breaks shouldn't just international game qualifiers or friendlies or whatever should be played during the summer or not at all. Because they're completely pointless. It's even as a Liverpool fan, our next game is Everton. But what happened to Seamus Coleman is a fucking disgrace. And it wouldn't have happened if he hadn't been playing for Ireland. Now, I know Neil Taylor, or I think is the player who tackled him, I don't know. Well, I'm assuming because he got the red card, that's what happened. Neil Taylor, I think if the right player is the left back for Swansea? Or is he a center back? I don't know. I know he's a defender. I think he plays for Swansea if I have the right player. That could have happened in the Premier League. But it happened on international duty. You can't overlook that. Calm. Say what you want, you can't deny the facts. It's as simple as that, ladies and gentlemen. International football should just not happen during the season. They're a waste of time, and all they do is end up getting someone hurt. Crucially hurt during the season. Like I said, I'm a Liverpool fan. You guys know that. And if you did just found my channel, well, I think you would notice from the overload of Liverpool videos I have done and that I'm a Liverpool fan. Our next game is Everton. Everton are our city rivals. Other than Manchester United, they're the team with her are in grade to hate the most. Seamus Coleman did not deserve that. And it wouldn't have happened if he was not playing for Ireland. That's my case, and it's closed. Nothing else can be said on the matter. International football, well, I just cancel it because it's a waste of goddamn time and no one cares about it. Really, no one cares about it. And if you do care about it, you're a liar. You're a liar. I mean, The only ones who get kind of excited about it are the English fans. And then when they realize they're completely shit because it's not 1966 anymore, then and they get knocked out of whatever tournament they're in, then they go back to, then they go back to the depressed about international football. So just cancel it. It's a complete waste of time. No one cares.
Competition.
We care about football for clubs like this game, like any game between two club teams. No one cares about football or international teams. No one. Fuck the World Cup. Fuck the Euros. Fuck the Copa America. Fuck it all. Just
individuals on the night.
Fuck international football. And that will be the title of the video.
Madrid lineup.
Fuck international football.
Diego Godin starts, looking to continue his good form at the back. Antoine Griezmann plays together with Angel.
But all right, that should be the cap.
Quite a few changes for
fucking
Madrid.
Title for every video. Just Danilo completely. Fuck.
Fullbacks. Toni Kroos starts with Casemiro in the centre of the pitch. Karim Benzema is the lone striker today. Good forward play from them. Excellent play too. Loses mark. He's got his shot off now. Terrific stop.
Let's get back to more important things. Like real football. And our international breaks.
A lot of newspaper inches devoted to this particular manager and the temptation of an international job, but we understand that he's turned that down.
Yeah, well,
this is how they love to play on the break.
Henderson.
Oh, great work by the keeper. Here comes
Saul, keeps it alive. Bale.
It's going to be a real target for victory for Real Madrid here. And if they don't get complacent, they should be able to achieve their goals.
Short. Here's Bale again.
Keeping the ball. Fouled by Felipe Luis. Free kick.
Yeah.
Here's Luis Felipe.
Is that the first yellow card I've done all season? Kidding me, right?
Close! Great work from the goalkeeper.
I don't remember. Oh, no, wait. Anderson got one in early in the season.
Atletico Madrid now, attacking dangerously.
I think that's the first one to win.
And he goes for goal with his head.
I fully admit that was definitely the careful for the rest of the game.
Five games. But on this ground against this opposition to make it
hard when you're coming up against the pace of guys like Gareth Bale and Cristiano Ronaldo. You just
tends to take the sting out of the situation.
No, you have to try and stop them somewhere.
Defender to it first. A lot of defenders between them and the goal, but they still got the ball. Shot off! No!
Well, the defenders
really, Griezmann, really,
because they've been left for dead, but he just couldn't finish it.
Come on, win the header. Yes.
Angel Correa. Real
Correa.
To put them in front.
Griezmann. Yes. 1-0. The Madrid.
It's found the back of the net again.
He has its first goal. And goes to the red and white corner.
With a fine goal.
Was a good goal. And it came at a
from Antoine Griezmann.
Captain's input there.
Takes the touch. See, in that situation, the touch, which is a good thing. Because it perfectly sets up that sweet finish. 19 goals for the season. Antoine Griezmann
has opened the scoring.
King boss.
Such an impregnable side at the moment. The home team today, they've won their last 10 games.
It's been formidable from this side that doesn't seem.
Koke takes the ball. Ooh.
Turned it aside.
And I don't know why, but I kind of saw an opportunity and I went for it. Casilla was equal to it though. He was not beaten. By the attempting thunder strike
to attack. The shot's on.
Miranda! Oh. Not exactly who you'd expect to hit him. Hit a long one, but to be honest, I didn't realize who was taking the shot until his name popped up. I wasn't really paying attention to which player it was.
And he could get away here.
Griezmann? Oh, see you with the save.
It's a corner.
He has second goal before the halftime break.
Came in with a challenge. And the decision for the time is 3 minutes.
Felipe Luis.
Some potential in this move. Here's the cross.
It's into a good position. Correa! Terrell! Right on the stroke of half time.
By two now. They'll feel a little bit more comfortable in there. Good value.
That gives me some good momentum going into that second half.
That left hand side, wonderful.
A really
accurate cross.
But you know what?
Hit harder than that first goal. Oh. Zidane must be absolutely livid.
Widen the margin here to 2-0. Pepe. And the referee is blown for half time. It's 2-0 here. Well, with their defence, I think they'll feel.
Half time means the switch between Gaetan and Carrasco, but other than that, same team will pretty much be
we're into the second half with
going
up
the second half.
In front.
That 2-0 lead.
Past his man. He's got his shot off now. Terrific stop. And it's out for a throw for Atletico Madrid.
Casemiro clears it away before any danger can come Real Madrid. The way of Madrid goal. The Real Madrid goal, I should specify.
Yeah, he couldn't have connected any better with the header, but really good agility from that keeper.
We have a substitution coming up, and it's coming up for Real Madrid. Well, now they've won the ball back in the middle of the park by intercepting that pass.
Griezmann.
Good progress with this attack.
Griezmann. What a fight. Oh, see again.
Will be a corner.
Despite how you can see it twice, Garcia has made some really important saves in this game so far. Block. It's going to come back to Koke. Correa.
Felipe Luis.
Luis.
Supporting player alongside. Nice idea with the through ball. Didn't come off though. Well, we're 2/3 of the way through the 90 minutes. Half an hour to go.
Anderson.
Real threat from Atletico Madrid in these positions.
Ah.
Gareth Bale. Saul.
Saul.
Defender to it first. Here's the chance. Another
crap. Oh. Pepe, motherfucker.
Atletico Madrid now attacking dangerously.
Griezmann. Correa.
Went for it. Good play, this positive play to try and increase their lead.
Skies it. Brilliant.
Saul. This could be it.
Griezmann. 3-0! And that should...
It's found the back of the net again.
End this Madrid derby with 3 points going to Lane. He gets it.
And two very well taken goals. It's given them a comfortable situation here. 3-0 as the game gets underway. We can go to Alan McAnally now. News of a goal from elsewhere.
It's a goal from Malaga. 73 minutes played. 1-1.
Thank you very much, Alan. And in he goes with the tackle. It's looking a real uphill climb for
Barcelona.
Madrid.
Concede against Malaga.
They need a goal and they're piling everybody forward.
Where it's now 1-1 between the two teams.
Koke. Well, we're nearly over here.
Correct.
It has been a big surprise. It looks as though it will be an even contest. It's been anything but that. On to the attack now.
Griezmann. In for Correa. Oh, Ramos gets there first to prevent the goal.
Ronaldo gone in this game.
Well, the defenders will be pulled.
Full difference between 4
now. Of, shot success or lack of it because they really.
Ronaldo's not really been in this game.
Goes for goal with the header. Straightforward stop for Kiko Casilla. Now they've got a chance in this part of the pitch.
Griezmann. Griezmann! Oh, see, there's enough to prevent the hat-trick.
Well, here we can see the corner count so far. That's proper clearance. Well away
okay.
From the danger zone.
Whoops in. Salt! Off the bar!
At the bar on the way through.
Unbelievable.
Now we've only got 4 minutes remaining in the match. Shot on! Shot blocked here.
Third time.
Looked very good indeed, but the
cruise in the face.
Broken down.
That's cleared away. Wait, it's coming back. Griezmann gets the hat trick right in the 90th minute.
He's made them pay, and that completes a wonderful hat trick.
Wraps up the game very nicely.
Well, no wonder he's
I do say so myself.
In a super celebration. To get a hat-trick is a fantastic experience, and he's just done that.
Well, having scored two, he was just so full of confidence, and he never looked like missing that chance.
Modric. Real Madrid looking good with this attack. Toni Kroos. And shoots! All right. Recall, Alan, the goalkeeper actually touching the ball in this game.
I wonder, will that go down as a shot? Because that might, I think that was the, if it does, that might be the only shot they had on target.
Well, they're going to really...
Shot. It wasn't even on target. Did that go down as a shot? Apparently they had 3 shots. I don't remember 3 shots.
La Liga. Athletic Bilbao 2, Villarreal 2. Atletico Madrid.
Anyway, Real Madrid. That is the end of this episode.
Barcelona 1, Malaga.
Well, thanks for watching. I'm Joy. Smash the like button if you did. Subscribe if you're new. And until next time, I hope you all have a very, very nice day. Peace.
So, what do those results mean to the league table? At the top of the table remain Atletico Madrid with 33.